And so I say, "That's not my leg. That's my tail." Oh, this isn't a bar. Where the hell am I? If I didn't know any better, I'd say I was summoned to the mortal plane. And if I didn't know any better, I'd say you were the one to summon me. I'm sure I need not introduce myself, because judging by the stupefied look on your face, you weren't expecting me. So tell me, just who were you expecting? Well, are you gonna speak? Do mortals appear not know English anymore? Come on, out with it. You really don't know who I am. So you draw your funny little symbol on the ground, say some magic bibbidi-boppidi-boo words, and don't even realize what you've done. Well, I guess introductions are in order then. I have went by many names. Beelzebub, Mephistopheles, the Dark One, Satan. But they all sounded so formal. So, I normally go by Lucifer. But for a cutie like you, you can call me Luci. My horn and tail? Well, many religions depict me with or without horns. Wings like that of a bat, or tainted angelic wings signifying my fallen status. No, most of those are you mortals painting me as a villain. Devil on your shoulder kind of thing. But in reality, I'm just little old me. Well, I do sometimes wear the horn and tail. Easier to blend in around Hallow's Eve after all. You thought I was a man. I mean, the devil comes in many shapes and sizes. But that's besides the point. Let's turn the conversation back to you, human. Tell me, what made you wanna summon me? Oh, come on. You have the Princess of Hell herself in your living room, and you're gonna try and be all bashful. Is it perhaps the small, black cocktail dress that's distracting you? Or how close I'm standing to you? Maybe there's something else that's distracting you then? Look into my eyes. What is it you desire most of all? Go on. You can tell little old Luci your secrets. Your cardinal desire. Your shameful acts. I won't judge you. If anything, I'd probably encourage you to do it. That's it. I can tell it's right there, just sitting on the tip of your tongue. Go on, tell me. You know you want to. Come on, let's have it.
Wait. I'm sorry, you want me to what?
No, I heard what you said. I guess I'm just confused. You want me to cuddle with you? Oh, for the love of... No, of course you're attractive enough. I just thought you'd have something more primal you'd want to do with the Princess of Hell. So, just to be clear, you tried to summon a demon from the depths of Hell for... Cuddles.
I mean, I'm not questioning your tastes. I'm just in awe that you'd go so far to get some companionship. Although, I must ask, if you weren't trying to summon me, who were you trying to get? No, mortal. I'm not laughing at you. Succubi are indeed desire incarnate. They will fulfill pretty much any desire you humans can think of. I just thought you'd have something deeper you wanted. Something more chaotic or destructive. But I think you got much more than you bargained for. Wouldn't you agree, sweetie? Well, you did summon me for a good time. Might as well hold up my end of the bargain first, hmm? Come, take me to your sleeping quarters. It is much easier to cuddle whilst lying down, wouldn't you agree? And as cute as these heels are, they are downright torturous to my feet, pun intended. So, this is the fashion trends of the century, huh? Oh, no, cutie. No judgment here. If anything, I like what I'm seeing. And in more ways than one, if you catch my drift. Your bed chambers are, straightforward. It doesn't scream for attention, but nothing stands out against one another. Perhaps if one of the walls were red. I'm joking, mostly. Now then, get on the bed. The bedroom is one thing, but cuddling is very hard to do when standing. So lay down and relax. Very good. You listen quite well, don't you? Oh, come now. Don't look so terrified. I don't hurt humans, well, unless they ask or deserve it. Desire is my bread and butter. I will admit, this is a new form of temptation I have not explored for quite some time. Now, rest your head on the pillow, and I'll go around to the other side and lay down with you, okay? See? Nothing to be scared of. Close your eyes and tell me what troubles you. Cuddles are one thing, but clearly you have a lot of repressed emotions and turmoil in that pretty little head of yours. Tell me, what's on your mind? Oh, you don't say. You're not sure what to do or where you are going with your life. That is a lifelong conundrum with humans, isn't it? I mean, I cannot imagine the things you have gone through to get to where you are now. But I can tell, you are a fighter. You don't give up easily, and you have been through many trials and tribulations. That has made you stronger than most mortals, or so I'd say. People have painted you as a villain in their eyes, forced you to witness the greatness of their own achievements, while you wallow in your own self-deprecating thoughts about why the world is so cruel and unyielding in this attempt to weed out the strong from the weak. Sorry, I got a little carried away, I suppose. I'm here for you, not the other way around. All I'm getting at
is the world is not simply black and white. There are other colors in the spectrum. So stop thinking about what if this or what if that. Stop with the I'm not good enough or I can't do that. Live your life the way that many other mortals do. Do you think that in my time people change their careers or do something abstract and out of the norm? Break free of your own constraints and confines and live it. Do what you want and take every chance to chase your desires. If you want something, just grab it and run like hell. If it makes you feel any better, you can always blame it on me. Been having you humans use me as a scapegoat since the dawn of time after all. The devil made me do it, and whatnot. I mean, I really don't do anything to force you mortals to do whatever. I simply give you suggestions. Maybe give you a little slap on the back to encourage it. But I'm not locking people up and threatening them to do something. The power of choice has been something I've craved for myself for some time. You humans are lucky. You have the power of free will and choice. You can wake up and change the very being of reality into whatever it is you want it to be. I guess in this instance, it's summoning Lucifer to cuddle you in your bed and talk about your personal issues, huh? Well, as much as I would love to stay here, the souls of the damned won't punish themselves now, will they? Hmm? Payment? What do you mean? Oh, you thought I'd take your precious mortal soul. Oh goodness, no. I find you too adorable to collect. That, and I find you much too interesting for whatever this was to be over so soon. I tell you what. Why don't we make a little trade, You continue to enlighten me with more of your human problems, and I will continue to provide you with reassuring affection in whatever form you so desire. So, do we have a deal? Exquisite. I see this anew and budding relationship between us. For now, though, I will send one of my finest succubi to entertain you in my stead, if that's quite all right. Marvelous. Well then, until we meet again, mortal.